Hello and welcome to SAP Tech App 2020. My name is Thomas Ferry and I'm in the product management team for SAP Analytics Cloud. Thanks everyone for attending this session. It's great to present you some new topics we have started working on in the past, but also for the technical guys, there's some interesting stuff in there. Besides the analytics designer and others, the performance monitoring was one of the areas we started to support our development colleagues. I would like to give you a brief introduction now, what we have developed together with the cross-engineering team so far, and what we ship directly to the tenants. At the end, I'm going to give you a short presentation. So why did we actually do that? What was the need for performance monitoring? So historically, if you wanted to analyze SAP Analytics Cloud performance in detail, you really needed some expert knowledge. During a story or analytic application runtime, you needed third-party tools like the Google Chrome developer tools to access the HTTP traffic. That was the only possible way for the customers to analyze the performance for each step widget by widget. This requires extra knowledge and is time-consuming. In addition, the analysis was only possible during the actual runtime of the story or analytic application execution. This means whenever an end user had a performance problem, they had to export an HAR file and send this then to the support teams for analysis. This has really been time consuming for our internal support team as well as for the customers teams that are supporting SAP Analytics Cloud. One huge step forward is that we are collecting these performance statistics for each tenant now. We write them internally into each 10 database. The development colleagues provided the infrastructure to extract the data from the HTTP traffic, as well as the calculation views on top of that data, which are actually showing the statistics that have been collected. The big advantage of this is that we are collecting historical information. Thus, on one hand side, it's no longer necessary to analyze and collect the data manually during the runtime, and on the other hand side, we can access now historic data that can be taken into account during the investigation of performance problems. So we collect the statistics internally in the tenant database, which is stored into internal tables, and then it can be accessed via internal SAP HANA calculation views inside the tenant. The information is exposed to SAP Analytics Cloud via live models on the top of the calculation views. These are the two live models, the cubes with the live model icon, which are shown here. It's the SAC Statistics MDS Query Performance and SAC User-Friendly Performance Action models. Basically, that's the content that has been shipped by our development team. We from product management connected with the different and various customers, collect some feedback, what's important for the customer scenarios, what we need on performance statistics side. And we did come up with the first story to analyze the data inside those live models. To summarize again, this performance statistics and analysis story is built on top of the two live models, which are pointing to the tenant database where the statistic information is stored. It's statistics of stories and analytical applications that are going to a detailed level of data sources, queries, query types, and various others information that is stored internally. The analysis of this data enables us to identify potential bottlenecks in the backend systems and show statistics across the tenant to go further and get an insight on what's running on SAP Analytics Cloud against the connected backend systems. The data retention times, maybe just to take this question, which might come initially, is based on row count. Currently, there is a limitation on the tenant database, how many rows can be stored inside the specific performance tables, and they get deleted according to the first in, first out principle. But this is something we are aware of, and we plan to offer either an export or download of the information or extend the storage which is used inside the tenant database. We have the option to just consume the existing story, which is built on top of that. And we are also planning to build an additional analytic application with more functional enhancements into more detailed analysis. So you can either just consume the performance story or copy it and adjust it to your needs. That is also possible for our customers. And we found out also a new way of how we ship this content. So it's not part of the sample content, which needs to be activated and installed via the analytics content network, but it's shipped directly into the system folder. So that was the architectural overview. And now I would like to explain you how the data is collected and how it's stored in the internal database before we go into the database and consume it. So on the left-hand side, you have your browser and your SAP Analytics Cloud system. And on the right-hand side, your direct connection to the on-premise data source. That would be the connectivity. First, the browser requests the story, gets the story definition from the SAP Analytics Cloud system, and also some statistics that are stored inside the browser session. And then you might have, for example, a chart widget, which gets the response from the backend system. And inside that response from the backend system, we deliver some query statistics. For example, on a BW system, we include the session ID and step ID, as well as some database statistics in the backend. And more or less everything is written to the browser session. This data is not collected and written with each response. For performance and communication reasons, it's only collected at a certain point in time. There's an array inside which stores all the information, and then with the user-friendly perf log and the query statistics persist call to SAP Analytics Cloud, it's sending back the statistics to the SAP Analytics Cloud tenant, and there the statistics are being written to the internal database. That means that anything that comes from the story or analytic application is stored first inside the browser, collected, and then sent with those two types of requests. If you look at the HTTP traffic to SAP Analytics Cloud, that is how the data flow looks like and how the performance statistics are collected. They are stored inside the tenant itself, and the administrators have then access to this information via different models which have been built on top of that. And I would like now to show you how you can access those models, how you can find them in your system, and also how you use the corresponding story. The two models and the story are located in the system file directory in the folder SAC content. This place is different from what you already know from the analytics content network, where you had to download and install new content. With Wave 2020-14 and QRC 3, we introduced the story performance statistics and analysis and the SAC statistics MDS query performance model. This is backend related performance data. But three waves later, with 2020-17, we came up with front-end related KPIs and measures, as well as enhanced the story to its actual state. On the following two slides, I would like to get you an overview of the measures and dimensions that are exposed via the live models before we jump into a demonstration in the system. The backend model, SAC Statistics MDS Query Performance, was the first model that we exposed to SAC via SAC content with Wave 2020-14. It contains only a few measures which are sufficient to show total averages and maximum runtimes, as well as the data throughput. All dimensions which are needed to analyze a unique execution, as well as to aggregate data and show historic values, are given. The second model is the front-end model. It's called SAC User-Friendly Performance Action. Here you see a cert table containing some actions that we track, like load and open story and log on. It aims to give an idea how the system is used and how it feels from an end user perspective. I don't want to spend too much time on this rather pure technical information, but it's helpful to know the model to be able to create a copy of our story to customize the analysis. Now I would like to give you a short demonstration of the content in the system, where you can find it, what it is about, and how you actually can use it to take benefit out of it. Welcome to SAP Analytics Cloud New Performance Content. Once you have successfully logged on to your SAP Analytics Cloud system, you need to navigate from the home screen to the file browser. You will jump automatically to the My Files directory. The new content is located in the system folder, which can be accessed via the menu at the left. The system folder is located at the top of this menu.
Once we navigated to the system files directory, we can access the new folder SAP Analytics Cloud content. The first version of this content is available since Wave 2020.14 and 2020 QRC3. In this initial version, we shipped the analytic model, SAC Statistics MDS Query Performance, and the first version of the story Performance Statistics and Analysis. This story was formerly named Backend Application Performance as it contained backend statistics only. With Wave 2020.17 and 2020 QRC4, it has been renamed to its actual name, Performance Statistics and Analysis. In addition, we introduced a second analytic model, SAC User-Friendly Performance Action. This model contains basic front-end statistics. Let's have a look at the story itself now. The story contains of 5 pages: the overview, the backend statistics, the backend analysis, front-end statistics, and the front-end analysis. We will go through each of them now, starting with the overview. The overview consists of 4 sections: the filter bar, the sub-analytics cloud KPIs, the backend KPIs, and the front-end KPIs. The filter bar opens the possibility to either select a specific time range like the current day, week, month, or quarter, as well as the possibility to filter for a specific connection only. The 3 KPI sections are linked to the filters and changed based on the criteria. Now we are going to have a deeper look at the KPI sections. Starting with the SAP Analytics Cloud KPIs that show the number of users, the number of models, the resource count, and the unique resource count. The number of users and models show the total number of users and models that cost processing time in the connected backend systems, and should not be confused with the total number of users and models created in the system. The resource count shows the total number of stories and analytic applications that have been used, whereas the unique resource count tells us how many of those resources were unique. In our case, 72 unique stories and analytic applications have been opened 260 times. The variance values besides the charts show the variance to the previous period. Our next section is the backend KPIs, which help you to monitor trends. They provide an overview on the averages of query runtimes and number of queries. In addition, we show the total, minimum, and maximum for the number of queries against selected backend systems. Below this KPI section, we show top 5 for connections, resources, and users by the query count. This shall help you to detect potential candidates that may have an impact on backend system performance. The front-end KPIs are the last section on the page. We see the number of log-ons to SAP Analytics Cloud and the median for both the log-on duration and the resource open duration. Below these KPIs, we show the top 5 users and resources based on log-on duration and open story and analytic application duration. This might help you to identify candidates for performance improvement potential. We helped you to identify active users, most used connections and models, and resources with high processing time. Let's have a look at the statistics page. At the statistics page, we extended the filter section by username. After having applied your filters, you have a look at the already known KPIs. We decided to repeat them here to open the possibility to apply even more detailed filters. Those KPIs are followed by the section Query Execution Count and Average Execution Time. The chart shows the relation between query runtime and query executions. According to the date range filter, the time series adopts and gives you a history that might help you to detect trends or suspicious patterns. Below the chart, we show a top 10 table for models with most number of queries against the backend systems and the average query runtimes. If you want to see the history for one of those models only, simply click on it and the chart above will filter for that specific model. If one of the connections, models, or users caught your attention and you would like to analyze it further, you need to jump to the backend analysis page. For this page, we extended the filter bar by model name and resource name because you might also be interested in a specific model or story or analytic application. If you're not having already a user connection or model in mind that you would like to analyze, we suggest you potential candidates with the top fives on those by query count. Having this said, we move to the performance impact. One model can be used in one or more stories. Sometimes the model itself is performing well, whereas the combination of the model and story can cause a performance issue. We show the model and story combinations with the most impact in the backend system, as well as the average query runtime, the number of queries, and the data throughput. By selecting one or more combinations in this table, we get statistics on runtime, number of queries, and the runtime distribution in the backend system. We are able to detect trends or patterns, etc. We can see whether there was a specific date, since we see increasing queries or runtimes, and we are able to judge whether the runtime distribution in the backend system is healthy or not. In this example, we see from October 14 a decreasing number of query executions, but an increasing average query execution time. This is suspicious, and it should, for example, be checked whether the story or the model changed and what causes this behavior. We finished the backend part now, so let's move to the frontend statistics. The frontend statistics page is structured into three sections: a filter section, a KPI section, and a section with historic values for log-on count and duration, as well as the median open resource duration. At the frontend statistics page, we extended the filter section for the user similar to the backend statistics and also repeat the KPIs from the overview page to open the possibility to apply even more detailed filters on frontend measures. The log-on count and median section provides two charts. The first sets the relation between log-on count and median log-on duration to show you possible trends or suspicious patterns, whereas the second chart shows the history on median resource open duration. More details on specific users and stories follow at the front-end analysis page. The front-end analysis aims to detect long-running resources and users that suffer under high log-on duration. Thus, we have a filter section for user and resource, followed by a section that shows log-on and load statistics for the same. The first table shows us the top 10 users per median log-on duration with information of total log-on duration. Besides the table, we provide historic context via a time series chart that can be filtered via the top 10 table to show only log-on durations for a specific user. The second table and chart combination shows us the top 10 resources per median open duration with information of total open duration. The interaction works analog to the above. That's our new SAP Analytics Cloud Performance content. We hope you like it.
I hope you liked the demonstration in the system and you now know what you can achieve with the pre-shipped models and the demo story. If you're looking for more information, here's a list of related SAP TechEd sessions for your interest. And if you want to continue your learning experience, please visit the Learning Hub. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.